Now, we continue our lesson with topic 2, mixture.
现在,我们以主题2,混合物,继续课文.
A mixture is made up of two or more different elements or compounds that are mixed physically but not combined chemically.
混合物由两种或多种不同的元素或化合物组成. 它们被物理上的混合在一起, 但并未经化学结合.
Not combined chemically is referring to no chemical reaction is occurred when the mixture is formed.
未经化学结合是指 形成混合物时没有化学反应发生.
Since no chemical reaction take place during the mixturing, there will have three scenarios to be concerned.
由于混合过程中不会发生化学反应, 因此会有三种情况需要注.
The first, no energy change, that is no light or heat released or absorbed involved.
第一,没有能量变化, 即是没有光或热被释放或吸收.
The second, no new substance is formed.
第二,没有新物质形成.
The third, it can be physically separated, using appropriate method.
第三,可以使用适当的方法,对它进行物理分离.
These are the three properties of mixtures and mixing process.
这些是混合物和混合过程的三个属性.
There are three types of mixture.
混合物有三种类型.
The first is elements-elements mixtures. It is formed when more than one type of element is mixed together.
第一是元素-元素的混合物. 它是当一种以上的元素混合在一起时而形成的.
The second is compounds-compounds mixtures. Compounds-compounds mixtures is formed when more than one types of compounds are mixed together.
第二是化合物,化合物的混合物. 当一种以上的化合物混合在一起时,化合物,化合物混合物就此形成.
The third is elements-compounds mixtures. Elements-compounds mixtures is formed when element and compound are mixed.
第三是元素,化合物的混合物. 元素和化合物混合时会形成元素化合物的混合物.
These are the types of mixture.
这些是混合物的类型.
Here is an example of mixture.
这里有混合物.
Milo drink is a mixture made up of Milo powder, sugar, and water.
美露饮料是由美露粉、糖和水组合而成的混合物.
Here is a question for you, is water and ice combination a mixture? And why? I believe you have the answer.
这里有一个问题要问你,水和冰的混合物是混合物吗? 为什么呢? 我相信你已有答案.
Now, we will discuss the methods to separate mixture.
现在,我们将讨论分离混合物的方法.
As a mixture is formed, when the original components are mixed physically, it can be separated physically too.
在原始成分的物质被物理混合后形成的混合物. 因此,它也可以被物理的分离开.
When a mixture is separated physically, no new substances are produced but the original components are retrieved.
当混合物被物理的分离时, 它没有生产新的物质,但回到了原始成分的原料.
The method to be used in mixture separation is depending on the two subject.
混合物分离所使用的方法取决于两个事项.
The first is physical properties of the components that make up the mixture. Example of physical properties is melting point, boiling point, density, and solubility. These physical properties of materials have been discussed in Chapter 5.
第一,构成混合物成分的物理性质. 物理性质的例子是熔点、沸点、密度和溶解度. 材料的这些物理特性在第五章已经被讨论过.
The second subject, the targeted components to be obtained from the mixture. That is, either component 1, or component 2, as shown in the image.
第二，从混合物中要获得的目标成分。如图所示，要获得的目标成分是成分一或成分二。
This is the two subjects need to be considered when you are selecting the methods to separate the mixture.
这是在选择分离混合物的方法时需要考虑的两个事项。
The follows are the six methods to separate a mixture physically.
以下是物理分离混合物的六种方法。
The first is filtering.
第一是过滤。
The second is distillation.
第二是蒸馏。
The third is separation using magnet.
第三是使用磁铁分离。
The fourth is sedimentation method.
沉淀法。
The fifth is floating method.
第五是漂浮法。
The sixth is chromatography.
第六是色谱法。
These six methods will be detailed in the following part of the lesson.
本课程的接下来的部分将详细介绍这六种方法。
The first method is filtering.
第一种方法是过滤
filtering.
Filtering is the method of separating mixture, that using filter funnel and filter paper.
过滤是使用漏斗和滤纸分离混合物的方法。
At which,The mixture must fulfill the following condition.
在此，混合物必须满足以下条件。
About the physical properties, it must be a mixture of insoluble solid and liquid.
关于物理性质，它必须是不溶性固的液体的混合物。
About the targeted components to be obtained. It can be either the insoluble solid or liquid.
关于要获取的目标元件。它可以是不溶的固体或是液体。
This is the two condition of mixture for the filtering method to be selected.
这是选择用过滤法来分离混合物的两个条件。
During the filtering, filter paper acts as a sieve, which has tiny pores. That can only allow the smaller liquid particles to pass through it. And the bigger insoluble solid particles trapped on the filter paper.
在过滤过程中，滤纸充当有细孔的筛子，它只能让较小的液体粒子通过，较大的不溶性的固体粒子被截留在滤纸上。
The liquid pass through the filter paper filtrate.
通过滤纸的液体被称为滤液
filtrate.
The insoluble solid particles that remain on the filter paper is called residue.
残留在滤纸上的不溶性固体粒子被称为残留物
residue.
Mixture of sand and water is the mixture that can be separated using filtering.
沙和水的混合物是可以通过过滤法被分离的混合物。
For the next, the distillation method to be discussed.
接下来，蒸馏法被讨论。
Distillation is the method that involves two processes, it is boiling.And condensation.
蒸馏是涉及两个过程的方法，即是沸腾和冷凝。
For your recall, boiling process is the process where matter change its state from liquid to gas. And it happen in point.
记得，沸腾过程是让物质从液态变为气态的过程。它发生在沸点。
Whereas,Condensation process is the process where matter change its state from gas to liquid. Condensation process happened when the gas flow to an environment where its temperature is lower than boiling point.
而凝结过程是让物质从气态转变为液态的过程。当气体流到温度低于沸点的环境时，冷凝过程就此发生。
Distillation is suitable to separate the mixture with the following physical properties.
蒸馏法适合分离具有以下物理性质的混合物。
Firstly, it is a mixture of soluble solid and a solution. Example, mixture of salt and water.
第一，它是可溶性固体和溶液的混合物。例如，盐和水的混合物。
It must be miscible liquid-liquid mixture, that they have different boiling point. Example, a mixture of alcohol and water.
第二，它必须是沸点不同的可混溶的液体液体混合物。例如，酒精和水的混合物。
During distillation, the salt solution is heated to the water boiling point. It continue until water is completely changed to water vapor, then water vapor is cooled. And it condenses to form pure water.
在蒸馏过程中，盐溶液被加热到水的沸点。加热继续，直到水完全变成水蒸气，然后水蒸气被冷却。然后被冷却的水蒸气凝结形成纯净的水。
The pure water is collected from Liebig condenser, is called distilled water, or distillate.
从里比锡冷凝器收集的纯净水被称为蒸馏水或溜出物
distillate.
The salt left behind is called residue.
留下的盐被称为残渣
residue.
Distillation process can be used to separate a mixture of water and alcohol.Which have different boiling point.
蒸馏过程可用于分离水和酒精的混合物。它们有不同的沸点。
Alcohol normally have a lower boiling point than water.
酒精的沸点通常比水低。
When the mixture is reaching 78 degrees Celsius, the temperature of the mixture will remain constant at 78 degrees Celsius for a few moments.Until ethanol is completely distilled out from the mixture.
当混合物达到78摄氏度时，混合物的温度将在78摄氏度下保持恒定一会儿。这恒定温度会持续直到乙醇，它是一种酒精，从混合物中完全蒸馏出来。
Temperature will continue to raise until 100 degrees Celsius, where water started to distill out.
之后温度将继续升高直到100摄氏度才开始蒸馏出水。
This distillation is called fractional distillation.
这种蒸馏被称为分流。
Fractional distillation is used in oil and gas industry to separate petroleum to its fractions, such as petrol, kerosene, and diesel fuel.
分流用于石油和天然气工业。以分离石油到其他六分汽油、煤油和柴油。
The third method, separation using magnet.
第三种方法，使用磁铁分离。
As magnets have property to attract magnetic substances, it can be used to separate mixtures of magnetic and non-magnetic substances.
由于磁铁具有吸引磁性物质的特性，它可用于分离磁性和非磁性物质的混合物。
The example of magnetic metals are iron, nickel and cobalt.
磁性金属的例子是铁、镍和钴。
The example of non-magnetic metals are gold, bronze and aluminium.
非磁性金属的例子是金、青铜和铝。
In general,Non-metals material are non-magnetic materials.
一般来说，材料属于非磁性材料。
The mixture of iron and sulfur powder are the example of the mentioned mixture. When a magnetic bar is held near to the mixture of iron and sulfur powder, the iron powder is attracted to magnetic bar, and sulfur powder will remain in the dish.
铁粉和硫粉的混合物是被提到的混合物的例子。当磁棒靠近铁和硫粉的混合物时，铁粉被磁棒吸引，硫粉将残留在碟中。
In food industry, magnetic separator is used to ensure that the metal pieces, such as iron particles, are not mixed with food products.
在食品工业中，磁选机用于确保金属碎片，例如铁粒子，不与食品混合。
The fourth method, Sedimentation method.
法沉淀法
Sedimentation method.
Sedimentation is used to separate mixture of liquid and insoluble solid.
沉淀法用于分离液体和不溶性固体的混合物。
During the sedimentation process, the heavy insoluble solid will settle down to the bottom of the mixture due to the gravity.
在沉淀过程中，重的不溶性固体将由于重力而沉降到混合物的底部。
A mixture of water and sand can be separated using sedimentation method.
水和沙子的混合物可以使用沉淀法分离。
When the mixture of water and sand is left undisturbed for some time, sand will sediment and two layers will be formed.
当水和沙子的混合物静置一段时间后，沙子将沉淀并形成。
Sand sediment to the bottom of container because sand is insoluble and denser than water.
沙粒沉淀在容器底部，因为沙粒比水难溶且稠密。
To separate the water and sand, water at the upper layer need to be transferred into another container. Without disturbing the sediment, the sand at the bottom layer.
为了将水和沙子分开，在不干扰沉积物底层的沙子的情况下，上层的水需要转移到另一个容器中。
Sedimentation method is used in water treatment process to obtain clean and safe water for the use of bathrooms, cooking, and drinking.
在水处理过程中，沉淀法被采用以获得清洁，用于浴室、烹饪和饮用安全的水。
Method is floating method.
第五种方法，漂浮法。
Floating method.Is used to separate mixture of two immiscible liquids with different densities.
漂浮法用于分离两种具有不同密度和不相容液体的混合物。
Immiscible liquids are liquids that do not dissolve in one another.
不互溶的液体是彼此不溶解的液体。
In floating method, the mixture of the two immiscible liquids with different densities.For example, mixture of oil and water filled in a separation funnel.
在漂浮法中，两种不同密度、不相容液体的混合物的例子就包括，例如填充在分液漏斗中的油和水的混合物。
Liquid with lower density, oil will float onto the top of mixture. And two layers of liquids is formed inside the separator.
密度较低的液体，油。会漂浮在混合物的顶部，分液漏斗内部形成两层液体。
Open the tap of the funnel and let the water at the bottom layer flow out into the beaker. Then, the oil is drained out to another beaker. The two liquids are separated.
打开漏斗的水龙头，并让底层的水流入烧杯，然后将油排到另一个烧杯中。二种液体被分开。
Now, we discuss the sixth method, chromatography method.
现在我们讨论第六种方法，色谱法。
Chromatography method is used to separate small amounts of substances from a mixture based on the differences in solubility of the components in a particular solvent.
色谱法基于成分在特定溶剂解度差异。从混合物中分离出少量的物质。
This method is used to separate two or more components that dissolve in same solvent in a very small amount.
此方法用于分离两个或多个成分，并相当少量的溶解在相同的溶剂中。
For example, a green food coloring, which is the mixture of yellow and blue coloring.
例如，绿色食用色素是黄色和蓝色的混合色。
To separate the coloring, one drop of green coloring is put on the filter paper. The filter paper is hung in a glass jar using lid. And the end of the filter paper is dipped into an ethanol. The ethanol is ensured not touch the green spot of food coloring.
为了区分颜色，我们将一滴绿色墨水放在滤纸上，用盖板将滤纸悬挂在玻璃罐上，然后将滤纸的末端进入乙醇中，确保乙醇不触及食用色素的绿色斑点。
After a short while, ethanol soaks up to the filter paper and carries the green food coloring with it. Different substance in the green food spot will move up the filter paper at different rate.
片刻之后，乙醇吸收到滤纸上，并带上绿色食用色素、绿色食品斑点中的不同物质，将以不同速度在滤纸上向上移动。
In food industry, chromatography method is used to analyze the sample of food coloring to identify the substance existed in a food sample.
在食品工业中，色谱法用于分析食物样品，以识别食品样本中存在的物质。
Chromatography method also used to the document fraud by separating the dyes in the ink used.
色谱法还可以通过分离所用墨水中的染料来防止欺诈。
All right, this is all the content of topic 2, mixture.
好的，这就是主题2混合物的全部内容。